suffering from low back pain? Are you suffering from sciatica? Are you suffering from slip disc? Were you advised surgery? Then are you looking for a very latest, advanced, effective and safe kind of surgery? Then you have a good news. I'm Dr. Kalyan. I'm a neurosurgeon and spine surgeon from Hyderabad. Keyhole spine surgery or endoscopic spine surgery is the latest advancement in the field of spine surgery. It is useful for the treatment of slip disc, and it is minimally invasive, safe and effective. In this video, I will explain you the technique of endoscopic spine surgery or keyhole spine surgery. And so what happens in a slip disc? The annulus develops a crack called annular fissure, and the nucleus protrudes into the annular fissure and exerts pressure on the annular fissure. Now, because of this crack, the patient will have back pain. The annular fissure further enlarges to form an annular hole, and the nucleus protrudes out of the annular hole. The nucleus protrudes further out, compressing the spinal nerve root. The compressed nerve root starts becoming red and swollen. This is called inflammation. And now patient will have pain radiating along the buttocks and legs. This radiating pain along with back pain is called sciatica. Further nerve damage causes numbness, weakness or paralysis, and bowel and bladder disturbance. Now let us see what is keyhole spine surgery or endoscopic spine surgery. This has a number of advantages. It is minimally invasive, causes very little muscle, nerve and bone damage. The skin incision and scar is less than 1 cm, and so it's cosmetically very appealing. It's very efficient. It has minimal complications or side effects. And after a successful surgery, the patient can walk home, can start walking within an hour and can walk home on the same day. So let us see how is this surgery done. First, the patient is made to lie down on the operation table on his abdomen. The position of exact level of disc herniation is confirmed with intraoperative image intensifier, which is also known as C-arm. With the help of intraoperative image intensifier or C-arm, the entry point is marked. Local anesthesia is infiltrated around the entry point. Some surgeons prefer a special kind of anesthesia technique called epidural analgesia. Here I want to stress the importance of local anesthesia. This surgery can be done under local anesthesia and it doesn't require general anesthesia. So this surgery can be performed even in those patients who cannot be given general anesthesia because of various reasons like heart disease, lung disease, liver disease, uncontrolled diabetes. So all these patients who have comorbids who are not fit for general anesthesia can also undergo this surgery. So let us come back to our original picture. This one is the herniated disc, which is compressing of the nerve root, causing it to swell and become red. In the first step, a long thin needle is slowly passed through the skin exactly to the location of the herniated disc. This is done under guidance of a C-arm. The needle is positioned into the herniated disc and confirmed with a C-arm. Gently, a narrow conical tube called dilator is passed over the needle. It gradually dilates the muscles to reach the herniated disc. So this dilatation is very gentle and it does not cause much damage to the muscles. The dilator is positioned into the herniated disc, and again the position is confirmed. A hollow tube called working cannula is passed over the dilator and the dilator is removed. Through the working cannula, the endoscope is passed. This is the endoscope. The endoscope helps in illuminating and magnifying the operative field. The endoscope is passed and the position is checked. Through the endoscope, the herniated disc is removed. Once the herniated disc is removed, the nerve root becomes free. Then all the instruments and the endoscope are removed. So this is the final picture where the nerve root is free. And so the nerve root recovers and the patient is relieved of back pain and the radiating leg pain. This is the final scar, which is less than 1 centimeter. So after a successful surgery, the patient is made to walk on within 1 hour and he will be ready for discharge on the same day or after an overnight admission. So hope you have all understood this new technology, which is called keyhole spine surgery and its advantages. So if you want to get it done, ask your surgeon regarding the keyhole spine surgery.